Sleepy Hallow helped put Brooklyn drill on the map. He broke out and hit the mainstream too. But instead of leaving the streets behind him, he stuck around the trenches, and now he's facing a RICO case that sounds like something out of a movie. And today we're breaking down the entire situation. Sleepy Hallow helped kick off a whole new wave of drill in New York and changed the entire sound of the city's rap game. But he's actually not even from Brooklyn. He was born in Jamaica, then his family moved to Flatbush when he was 5 years old. Flatbush is a wild area, and Sleepy had to adapt to the new environment fast. But while he was learning how to move in the streets of Brooklyn, Sleepy also had goals of becoming a rapper. Growing up, he heard a lot of different styles from his older brother and parents, and he started rapping at 12 years old. His house in Brooklyn burned down when he was in high school, so Sleepy ended up moving to Queens for a year and going to school out there. He already had a name in the streets, and a reputation almost got him jumped by 50 dudes at once. Chef G was coming up in the streets at the same time and would go to other schools and fight dudes. Sleepy and Chef eventually linked up and became the hottest drill rappers in Brooklyn, but back then, everyone wanted them to fight. They went on the Sakara show together a few years ago and explained how it all went down. According to them, Chef rolled up with a huge crew to put hands on Sleepy. They started screaming and yelling at him, but Sleepy just stood his ground and stared at them. Chef realized that Sleepy was on the same type of time as him, so he called off the beating and got tight with him instead. Chef and Sleepy both ended up dropping out of high school and getting deeper in the streets. Chef got booked on a felony gun and robbery charge, and Sleepy was arrested at 15 for weed. They both knew it was time to move smarter. And when Chef got released, they both hit the studio and started putting in work. Chef popped off with the first track, No Suburban, which was allegedly a diss track aimed at a rapper named 22G's. The beef between the Blickies, Chef, and Sleepy eventually turned deadly. But first, it allegedly got Chef stabbed in the head. He had a meeting with his probation officer one day, and after he left the spot, Chef ran into an op and ended up getting stabbed in the back of the head. It was never confirmed who cut him, but rumors say it was a dude named Nick Blicky. Chef never said who it was, but after Nick Blicky was shot and killed, Chef dropped the track Start Some Shit and rapped, "They thought that I switched cause I got famous and rich. Remember I got cut? The ops was all in a split." After Chef dropped No Suburban, him and Sleepy started linking up on tracks like Disrespect and Panic. For a while, Sleepy just hopped on Chef's tracks and wasn't dropping anything solo. But in 2018, he started making his own lane. Chef always had a more traditional drill sound, but Sleepy set himself apart from everyone with his unique style. He mixed drill rap with more melodic and mainstream beats that got him a lot of attention outside of Brooklyn. But while he was trying to break into the music scene, Sleepy still had real street beef going on, and in 2017, it almost got him killed. It's not clear who tried to take him out, but in 2017, Sleepy caught a bullet in the leg and one of his homies was killed right next to him. Getting shot ain't slow him down at all though. And on the track Flows, he rapped, "Fuck it, I'm stuck in my bad ways. I got shot, I ain't bitch, I just manned up." And in the middle of his genius breakdown of the track, Sleepy sent a message to the ops and said,
"Shoot me again."
His tracks with Chef are what had his name buzzing at first, but it didn't take long for Sleepy to prove he could pop off on his own too. In 2020, his deep end freestyle went viral and racked up hundreds of millions of streams. Plus, he became one of the first drill artists to go platinum. Sleepy and Chef started their own label, Winner Circle Entertainment, and in 2020, they scored a huge win by signing a deal with RCA Records. Sleepy was already on his way up, but 2021 was even crazier for him. He dropped his debut album, Still Sleep, and shocked everyone when it ran up numbers. The single 2055 hit over 500 million streams on Spotify and ended up going double platinum. And by that point, it was clear Sleepy was way more than just another drill rapper with a few trendy songs. Chef and Sleepy both could have left all the Brooklyn drama behind them and took over the industry, but that's not how it went down. In 2021, Chef got caught with a pistol and pleaded guilty to second-degree gun possession. He got hit with a 2-year sentence, but Sleepy was still holding it down for him in the rap game. But then in 2022, Sleepy caught his own gun charge and got locked up right when he was about to become a real star. Getting booked right then was definitely a loss, but luckily Sleepy only had to serve around 8 months over the case. He got out in February of that year, and Chef posted a video of him drinking champagne on the street. Fans knew that Chef should be coming home soon too, and they were ready for him and Sleepy to take over together. They were even scheduled to perform at Rolling Loud in July, but before it could happen, they got wrapped up in one of the craziest cases the rap game has ever seen. Chef and Sleepy both repped the A-Trey Gangsta Crips, and in May, news broke that they were both tied up in an indictment with 30 other alleged A-Trey and 9-Way affiliates. According to the indictment, they've been at war with the Folk Nation GDs and a set called the ICG Babies for years, and they claim Chef G was leading them. It's a massive case with 140 different charges against them, and the cops claim they're responsible for at least 12 shootings plus a murder that was caught on camera. Back in 2020, a Blicky affiliate named Sniper Blicky was shot and killed. There's footage of the hit going down, and the cops allegedly have texts, phone calls, and pictures that prove Chef and his crew are behind the hit. One of the craziest parts of the story is that they claim Chef took a bunch of shooters out for a steak dinner to celebrate after they killed Sniper. Sleepy was allegedly there as well, which means he probably knew what was going down in the streets too. The ICG babies allegedly clapped back and shot up Chef's house, and that's when the cops say Chef slipped through their territory. The day after his crib got hit up, Chef allegedly drove some A-Trays in his Jeep Trackhawk to the baby's hood and they started letting off shots. The cops had footage from that situation too. The war was already crazy, but what happened next is way more shocking. One of Chef's affiliates in the A-Trays allegedly gave his address to the ops, and that's how they almost took him out. After they found out about the leak, some other A-Trays allegedly found him in the street and put hands on him. That's not where it ended though. After they stomped him out, they allegedly kidnapped the dude and drove him to a cemetery. They pulled him out of the whip and started beating him up, but luckily someone called the cops and they rolled up before the A-Trays could finish the dude off. It's not clear how much Sleepy was actually involved with the beef though. The indictment named him as a co-conspirator, but they also let him out on bond, so the cops probably don't think he's involved with any of the shootings. Plus, his steak dinner could have just been another normal night out with the crew, unless police have more specific evidence. The indictment does say that Chef was on the phone with his sister Crystal, talking about some A-Tray houses getting raided. Then Sleepy allegedly joined the line and said, "Listen, let me tell y'all, if it's 7-0, it's over. If it's 7-0, it's clip, gangsta." Rumors say he was talking about the 70th NYPD precinct, which is the block where Chef and the A-Trays allegedly shot at the babies, but it hasn't been confirmed. Chef was originally supposed to get out in June, but now he'll probably be locked up until his new trial goes down. Fans were happy to see Sleepy Hallow out of jail, and at Rolling Out Miami, he even put Chef on the phone so he could talk to the crowd.
Shit like that. Hey, hold on. Let him talk to y'all real quick. Hold on. Hey, yo, talk that.
It's clear right now that nobody's forgotten about him, but that might change if he gets convicted in the new case. Sleepy's still popping off and dropping new tracks. There's no telling how far he could go in the industry without the legal drama, but right now he still has the case hanging over his head. Sleepy definitely has a better chance of winning the case than Chef. They just listed him as a co-conspirator, but Chef is facing wild charges like conspiracy to commit murder, and the cops think he was the one calling all the shots.